Yo, YouTube, what's happening, guys? How you guys been doing? I hope you okay. I'm fine. I want to show you a video today. It won't be a gameplay, but it will be... we will talk about the penalty to leave a game in ranked battles. And then we will talk how to just avoid it altogether. So this is on PS4. I think it can work on any console or any PC or any whatever, you know what I mean? Okay, so this is how it works. First, as you can see, now I cannot play for 593 minutes, 600 minutes, which is about 10 hours, right? So they implemented this when you leave the game in ranked. When you leave the game in normal mode, nothing happened, right? But when you leave the game in ranked, you get penalty. It starts small. I think it starts like 5 minutes, and then it goes up, up, up. I did read on internet that it can last up to 1 week, 7 days, which is kind of loud. I can understand the thinking behind this, like... It will prevent people from leaving the games and letting their teammates drive. But there is few problems with the system itself, right? Most of the time when I leave the game, it's because the guy pick up my banner, but he's not going to res me. So basically I'm stuck there, I don't know how long, watching their game, right? And I don't think that's quite fair. And you can actually troll people that way, right? If you have two teammates dead, you pick up their banners, so their banner don't expire, and they cannot leave the game, right? Because they have, if they leave the game, they get the penalty. So they need to watch the game, whatever, you know. Sometimes people you watch, they just sit in the corner and they don't fight or anything. They just sit there. They camp. So it's kind of boring watching, you know what I mean? If it was a good gameplay, when you a good player play, I can totally understand that I would stay and watch, you know what I mean? So that's the first problem. Basically, I think what they should have done, it's leave the penalty, all right? I don't think it will prevent anyone from quitting, because I'm just going to show you at the end of this video how you can avoid the penalty altogether. But leave it, whatever, you know what I mean? I don't think it will prevent people from quitting. I think it's totally wrong. People don't care, you know what I mean? They quit. Okay, you give me a penalty 1 week. All right, I go play Anthem. I go play Destiny. I go play COD. I go play something else, you know what I mean? Only thing they're going to win this way, it's people after a week, they probably won't come back. You know what I mean? They will be focused on something else, and they won't come back. So they're probably going to lose players by this thing. So yeah, definitely give a 7 days a penalty. I think it's way too much. I think it should not last more than like a 24 hours maximum. I think that's already a lot, right? If you want to keep a player race. So yeah, I think that penalty is kind of strangely implemented. And I think when you banner, it's picked up by someone. And the guy, for example, doesn't like revive you in 1 minute, 2 minutes. Leave him 2 minutes. 2 minutes is a long time in a game, you know what I mean? Leave him 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, you should be able to quit, you know what I mean? Without penalty. Because clearly the guy doesn't want to arrest you. And if he doesn't want to arrest you, you're not going to stay there, watch a screen for 10 minutes. You know, you want to play another game. Another thing that's really wrong about this, it's that you get blocked from playing normal mode, which is totally, like, stupid, I think. Because I can understand that you get penalty in ranked, but you should block ranked. You should not block normal mode. Normal mode is, like, stupid mode, you know what I mean? Like, that's the mode when everyone go in, they just shoot stuff around, you know what I mean? They don't care. So why blocking people in all the game? Basically, they block you from the whole content of the game. And I think that's kind of like a silly thing to do. So now, guys, I'm going to show you how to avoid all this together. So we're going to close. First, we're going to close this. There you go. There you go. All right. So the game is closed, right? Now, all you have to do is go to change. Make a new user, right? I made a new user, which is not my main, right? Make a new user. Log in with the new user, launch the game, And now, of course, you don't have the penalty because you play with another guy. You know what I mean? So the penalty is gone. So you can play. So as you can see, it doesn't really ban, like, the thing, it doesn't ban the account. It banned just one character. And in the game, it's so silly. There is nothing to win in the game. You know what I mean? The only thing you get in the game is cosmetic things. That you don't get anything else. So you can argue with me, yeah, but if I change the character, I play with a new character, then I don't have my guns and stuff. There is no guns. You know what I mean? The only thing you have, it's cosmetic. So it doesn't change anything that you play with another character. You know what I mean? Like, you don't lose anything, in my opinion. That's only my opinion, you know what I mean? And you can start playing ranks. I start playing ranks with this character, as you can see. And I'm bronze. I started playing today with this character. So, yeah, you can basically get in, like, 1-2 days another character, maybe even the same level, the other character. So it's totally stupid, you know what I mean? Like, look, now I can play whatever I want, you know what I mean? I don't have no penalty. So I hope this helps you guys. Just make a new character and play, you know, till you wait the block go away, you know, the timer go away, or just go play something else, you know what I mean? It's the same thing. But if you like Apex Legends and you want to play you want to keep going playing the game, well, just make another character. It's simple as that. Thank you for the video, guys. I hope it helped people. I think the system is badly implemented. I'm okay with the system. I just think that it should have been done differently. They should definitely not block you from playing the old content. The block should be only for the ranked game, and you should really, like, if he pick up your banner and he doesn't respawn you in 2 minutes, you should be able to quit. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, that's definitely two things that are totally wrong with it. And the third thing, we can say it's wrong, that you can argue that, of course, 1 week is like a stupid thing. I mean, you're gonna block someone for 1 week, I bet you a chance are huge that guy will never come back to your game. So if you enjoy losing, like, gamers and your baseline, you know, then you're going to end up like other games that die because there is no one online playing. And you log in, you want to play the game, and you wait like 10 minutes to get the game, and people will quit. You know what I mean? You're going to, I think the devs are shooting themselves in the foot by doing this, and I think it's a wrong move, in my opinion. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I see you guys next time. Bye bye.